shut up and sit down.
Now, I'll have to lean onto the frame to put weight on it. At the same time, pull the bolt off that holds that lower ball joint. Without shooting that spring off into wherever. So, get a good view of that just in case it happens. Now this is where you would use a spring compressor or a something like that. A spring compressor basically is all there is. Don't do coat hangers because they don't work. So, these are from 91, so I'd say they're wore out enough to where the frame or nothing's going to come shooting off. Then again, I just saw it raise quite a bit, so let's see if we can't get on it some more. Hopefully you don't see me shooting, hopefully you can still see it. Now I'm freaked out. Yeah, I'm laying up there. I'm pulling down a little bit, so let's see what I can do here. God, yep, nervous. Let's back off of it for a second here. Give me a second here. Grow some nerve. Okay, so I stuck my pry bar down in there so that way if it does happen to shoot the frame up, it won't shoot the spring out. So I got it to release. The only thing I can think of is it was stuck on the threads of the lower ball joint. It's the only thing I can think of. It's ridiculous. I've never seen nothing like that. But then again, the only time you knock them out is when the lower ball joint's like completely shot. And I'm taking mine off just for paint. Oh. It ripped my dust shield off. As if my dust shield was stuck. It's odd, I've never seen nothing like that either. Okay. Never should I get to pop the rest of the way off. again, still.
Whoo! Danger, danger, danger. Unbelievable.
Very dangerous, you're not supposed to do it this way. But alright. Well, I got it at that point, I might as well. Fight this upper ball joint off real quick with bolt on it. Dang. That thing is just coated in garbage. So let me see here. If I can get you to see. Right there, basically. This is the upper ball joint. And it is packed full of crap. And I know it's shot. I've never replaced it, so. You can find a cotter pee, it's got some, cotter key. So, let me clean that off so I can see what I'm doing. Okay, so before I pull it off, I think it'd be best to pull the top control arm off with all the brakes. So I'm gonna pull this off, which is my brake line, so that way I can just pull that whole top part out in one. I'm gonna take off these two bolts. When you're taking something apart like this, there's usually shims, so take good pictures of what you're doing. So that way you know how many shims are in there. And move the blinding light out of your eyes. Alright. Now I should be able to lift that whole part off. It's going to be heavy. Very heavy, I would say. Gotta bring it off there, so it should just be these slide back, I believe. Yep. We don't have 200 pounds of suspension on it. It's not actually 200 pounds, but it's heavy, I know that much. Now, we got cut off the dangerous part. The rest of that still. Alright, I'm gonna take a break here. So, after I got that top part off, I jiggled it around a little bit and dropped it a little lower. It's ready to come out now. In fact, it's ready to probably spring out of there. You know, looking at this, it looks like my spring is broken. My spring is broken. Huh. Okay, I didn't know that. Stick my hand in there, but I really don't have a choice. Huh. why the front end of this car probably sat so low forever. My springs are broke. Son of a... Well, that's definitely gotta be replaced now, no matter what. I hate when they're kinda in there, kinda not in there. Springs broke. Had no clue. Look at that. Right off the bottom. I was trying to figure out why my ride's so crappy. Huh. No wonder. Why it always felt like my stuff was loose. It didn't have it. What the crap? Well, I'm gonna call it for tonight and I'll be back tomorrow to pull that part off, pick up, take that part the rest of the way off, the brakes and everything. But right now I'm in shock mode because my spring is broke.